Prairie View. We rehearsed at TSU for many years in Third Ward. And I always dreamed of going to an HBCU. My college was Destiny's Child. My college was traveling around the world, and life was my teacher. I wanted a black orchestra. I wanted the steppers. I needed the vocalists. I wanted different characters. I didn't want us all doing the same thing. And the amount of swag is just limitless. Like, the things that these young people can do with their bodies and the music they can play and the drum rolls and the haircuts and the bodies and the, it's just not right. It's just so much damn swag.
Hello, my name is Cassine Ward, and this is my CAU HBCU story. I pledged Kappa at Clark, GK, phenomenal chapter, founded 1948. A lot of great people came out of the chapter. To put it in a nutshell, Kappa in so many ways saved my life. One time I was about to do something crazy. At one evening, and my line brother literally got in a fight, and he stopped me from doing something crazy. And you know, so Kappa saved my life. So in so many ways, GK saved my life. In so many ways, Clark Atlanta saved my life. So you can't put that in words. You can't put a price tag on you know, the organization as well as the university. Putting you in the best situation to have success. It was so much going on. When I got to school, I got to Clark in 2001. On campus, the music industry was just booming. I remember so many different artists, and being a student at Clark Atlanta, you became immune to so many different celebrities coming on the campus. A lot of them actually attended school there. If they wasn't attending school there, they was performing at the homecoming, such as Lil Jon. This was their era, that Crump Juice era. Usher was crazy popping. You had clubs like Illusion, Visions, and it was really like you were almost living in that music. The music, it was almost like a music video you was living in, because they were coming on campus, and you almost was able to even form relationships with a lot of celebrities. Outside of campus, outside of the Clark Atlanta world or the AUC world, I remember distinctively that the war was going on in Afghanistan. So, you know, and I particularly knew because I also was in Army Reserves, and my stepfather got mobilized. So outside of all the beautiful things that was happening at Clark Atlanta and getting my education, you know, outside of that, it was a war going on. So it was like a bittersweet type of experience, but I was so in love and being at Clark until it really didn't affect me as much as some others that probably wasn't blessed to be in my situation. Like I said before, the women and even a lot of the men, we was dressing to the T. Like, cats was walking around going to class with suits on. Women had stilettos on. So it wasn't even just about a fashion show. It was a fashion show every single day that you went to Clark. Everybody was putting their best foot forward, trying to look their best and trying to achieve. I could definitely say that, you know, Beyonce, you know, you would have definitely found your niche as far as being in the fashion scene. Fashion Week in New York, we had Fashion Week in Atlanta every single day. We even had where we had Market Thursdays, where a lot of the up and coming, whether it was young entrepreneurs, young artists, on Market Thursday, all of these people would have their businesses staged on the promenade. And you would, I remember literally going out there and purchasing clothing, you know what I mean? And then I had an artist, what was his name? Hebrew. Hebrew who actually painted on my shirt, who's really doing well now. So we had so many people that had came from Clark Atlanta, Hebrew Brantley, who came from Clark Atlanta, that is doing extremely well now. So you, Beyonce, you would have just added on to that, whether it was dance, music, fashion, you would have been able to just really flourish and blossom and connect with so many more people at that point. And that was the biggest thing I got out of Clark. Not only fashion, not only anything, but even to this day, I have so many positive people that I know, that I connect with, that I can look up to, that sit right next to me in class. I think Beyonce is beautiful, and not only is she beautiful, but she is charismatic and just a really determined and hardworking person. So those characteristics was definitely something that I'm attracted to. So, probably would have shot your shot. I'm a big person on energy. So if I'd have seen you and if you had an approachable, positive energy and a positive attitude, then I probably would have, just off of the positivity and the looks. I can say there was some celebrities and women that went to Clark Atlanta that if they had a negative attitude, that wasn't for me. But Beyonce, if your attitude probably was dope, and probably would have, I might have got my beak shot off like Daffy Duck, but I would have shot my shot.
Hi, I'm Michelle Wilson, and this is my CAU HBCU story. Some of the activities that I was a part of while at Clark Atlanta University for the 4 years, I was a cheerleader. My last year I was a captain of the cheerleading team, and I pledged Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated. I'm an ACE club. I also was in the management team, the management club, excuse me. I also was a part of the Women Initiative Program. I was also on the yearbook staff. I was also an orientation guide. I was also a TA for the B school. I was a business school graduate, so I was Dr. Kimball's TA. And a host of other things. I was really involved. I was on a debate team. I just did a lot. And every year I just found something new to get involved in, something that I was unfamiliar with to become familiar with. I wound up working at the school in Suite 250. So that was a lot of fun, where all the activities and organizations came out of. I was the second vice president of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated Sigma chapter. So that was a lot of responsibility there as well. My sorority, Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, means change. I think prior to going to school, a lot of people told me, you're gonna be an AKA, you should be an AKA, AKA. And so when I got to school, I was like, okay, what's all this AKA talk? What is all this about? What is all this Delta talk? What is all this about? Ironically, there were two cheerleaders that I'm still really close to this day that were Deltas. And when I think about it, when I come to the decision that I made to pledge Delta, it was just simply because Delta means change, and I felt like I was part of that change. And I love all my Greek sisters, AKAs, Deltas, Sigma Gamma Rho's, Zetas, but Delta is and was for me. So I think Beyonce would have loved her experience at Clark Atlanta University. I do know that she is also my Virgo sister, so I can only speak from a Virgo standpoint and feeling connected to Beyonce in that way. We make the best out of any situation given to us. And I think if that was her chosen HBCU, potentially maybe TSU would have been, because she's from Houston. But again, I'm from New Orleans and I wanted to go outside of Louisiana. I think Beyonce would have been involved with just about everything. I mean, she's around my age, so during that time frame, things were so different than they are now. So would she have pledged? Potentially, I could have seen her pledging or being a queen of some sort. You know, I was on the Omega Court when I was in college, and that was a lot of fun also. Our school is really a service-oriented school, so I could see her inventing a lot of the things that she's been inventing as an artist now while in school, and just having that core group of girlfriends and guy friends that are just family for forever. That's turned into family, is what we like to call it now. Mass Media Arts really ran the AUC. Something about Clark Atlanta University that a lot of people do or may not know, but we are the university on campus. So we have Spelman, we had Morris Brown, and we have Morehouse, and we can cross register. So while I was in school, anyone from Spelman can take a school, take a class at Clark Atlanta, Morehouse, vice versa. So I would notice that a lot of Spelmanites and a lot of Morehouse men would come to our mass media arts department because we have our own radio show. We have our own productions show. We had our own auditorium where we actually did a lot of things that people were doing in the filming industry right there in Clark Atlanta University. So a lot of people that graduated from Morehouse or Spelman, they took their mass media art classes at Clark Atlanta University. So I definitely think Beyonce would have felt like just fit right in, and she just would have been another one of those individuals that we now know that are in the industry that attended Clark Atlanta University.
I'm Robert Freeman. This is my Clark Atlanta HBCU story. Man, I played football and I ran track, man. And to be honest with you, man, me and my boys, man, we was hell now. Like, they knew us at Clark that we was going to get on the ladies. Definitely, we were ladies, man. We was running the show, so nobody got stupid with us. So we was kicking some ass. And at the same time, we was going to ball out in sports, whether it was football or track. And we was on the scene during the nightlife. We was out kicking it. We came in with damn near 100 people on the football team. You had big-ass linemen down and liberty-ass linemen. And it was like, you would think you were going to have to fight super hard for a position. But it was totally opposite. We had so many people. Half of them was so sorry. Like, for real. So I came in as a freshman and started my freshman year at cornerback. Wearing number 49. Now, Clark Atlanta, they hadn't had no history of winning for real. So we didn't get a chance to experience the winning at Clark Atlanta University. But I tell you this, though. Whether we won or lost, we gonna have a good ass time afterwards, though. Whether my old Mario was gonna have a party in his crib, or we was gonna go down to goddamn opera or something like that and party, we was gonna kick it. Whether we won or lost at Clark Atlanta University, so we made the best of our time down at Clark, but. You know, give and take, you know, we won some, we lost some. Overall, man, like, we didn't have a really good football team. I think we might have won about 11 games my whole 4 years at Clark. But I tell you this, though, we damn sure kicked it and enjoyed that HBCU experience. In 2003, I signed the NFL contract with the Tennessee Titans as an undrafted free agent. And when I went to the team, I honestly was like a long shot from making the team. So when I got to school, I was probably one of the smallest players on the team. But being the type of player I was, man, it was like the Napoleon syndrome. I was fast, mean, and can play some football. So them folks in the NFL were looking at me like, you made it to the NFL from Clark Atlanta University? From Clark Atlanta? What the hell did you have to do at Clark Atlanta for you to be able to sign an NFL contract? I said, shit, I was a dog on the field. I ran fast, and I took care of business. And I was able to sign a contract. Coach Atlanta, I heard her say that, you know, she always dreamed of going to an HBCU. She was talking about Prayer Review, you know. But if she came on out here to the A-Town, though, Clark Atlanta, yeah. Beyonce, Kelly, Toya, anyone of them. They're Clark Atlanta, yeah. We definitely would still try to get on them, fame or not. Best believe it. So, I think she would have probably been able to blend in, especially if she had the personality, because Clark Atlanta was, you know, we remember we had Eva out here going to school with us. We had some celebrities go to school with us, and all of them blended in and interacted with the students. And you know, Mace came out here and went to school with us. So if Beyonce came out here or not, you know, she still would have been treated like a regular student. So I pretty much, me or one of my boys, we would have probably tried to holler at her. Guaranteed. Whether we got shot down or not, yeah, we would have shot our shot. Best believe that.
I'm Mario Butler, and this is my CAU HBCU story. I ended up at CAU as a transfer student. Transferred to CAU in 2001 from PWI, University of Memphis in Tennessee. Came to Clark Atlanta on a football scholarship. Had the opportunity to continue my matriculation at Clark as a student athlete. I was always, you know, particular about how I looked when I went to class because, for one, a lot of people don't know this, but at Clark Atlanta, the ratio from men to women is like 30 to 1. So if you go to class, you're trying to look your best. You're like, man, I gotta come correct. You wanna make sure your hair's cut, your teeth brushed, your shoes clean, your outfit clean. And so, you know, that would be times I would actually go to the store and buy an outfit just to go to class. And, you know, walk on campus, you know, post up for a minute, and I would see all these women walking down the promenade, walking across from the student center, just, you know, high heels on, stilettos, Manolos, and just all your top fashion brands. You know, that was really, you know, something that we was really into back, you know, back in our time frame. And it was like, you know, the women knew who was really doing their thing out here. So it was like, yeah, if you ain't clean, they could tell. If you, like, back then, you could really tell where a person really shopped at, because we didn't have stores like H&M. We didn't have stores like Urban Outfitters, where everybody could get fresh. You know, like back then, you could tell if a person got they clothes from Sears, or if a person got their clothes from, you know, Neiman Marcus. Because we really, it was kind of hard to get clothes from a bootlegger. It wasn't as popular back then. But we did go to the flea market sometimes and get our shoes. So I'm gonna let y'all know that now. We did used to get those Air Force Ones, man. So we would come to school with a fresh pair of Air Force Ones every day, and the girls be like, "Dang, you fresh, man." We would get them shoes for $30. $30 a pop, you know. So we'll come in, I got four pair of fresh Air Force Ones, and I'm wearing new pay every day. So they like, "Dang, man, he got some money." So, you know, but you know, it was all about building yourself and trying to make yourself look good. At the same time, representing for the university, trying to finish up and graduate. I ended up graduating in 2004 with a degree in mass media arts and a concentration in TV and film. And then I ended up doing an internship at Channel 46, and the internship went pretty good. And I graduated, they offered me a job, but I declined the offer because I ended up going to play professional arena football in Texas for Rio Grande Valley Dorados. And so after that, I continued playing arena football for the next 2 years. And I figured that, you know, I was like, I need to go back to school. So while I was actually playing arena football, I enrolled back in school to get my master's degree in business with a concentration in healthcare management. And so after I graduated with that, I stopped playing arena football, and then I ended up going into the healthcare industry, and I ended up starting a mental health clinic, which has now been open for the past 11 years now. And so we provide all your mental health services for adults, children, adolescents. And I also had an opportunity to tap into the blockchain technology and cryptocurrency industry, where I invest in different tech projects. Just from my experience of playing football and being at a predominantly white institution, the guys on the team and the players, everybody was kind of separate. Everybody, you know, went their own way after football practice or after the game. Everybody kind of split off into their own groups. But at the HBCU, it was more like, man, we stick together. Like after a game, whether it's win, lose, or draw, we go hang out. We go places. Somebody might have an after party. I might throw an after party. I've thrown a lot of parties, after parties, house parties. I was kind of like that guy, you know, that go-to guy, you know. I was a pretty good player on the football team as well. Standout defensive back. You know, just did my thing. Just had a good time. Standout defensive back, punt returner, kick returner. Played safety, strong safety, all of that, you know. Led the team in tackles at one point, you know, had a couple of interceptions and, you know, just doing my thing as an athlete. And, you know, coming out of high school, I was a state champion in the 400 meters track, but I never did get a chance to join the track team because I had so much other stuff going on. And the track coach, she was always mad at me, Coach Page. And she was always like, man, when you gonna come out here and run track? But I was like, Coach, I'm so tired, you know, just from being a parent, trying to have my own time, going to football practice, going to class. It was like no room for another activity. And I saw that Beyonce always wanted, you know, she said she always wanted to go to a HBCU, TSU, and she was, you know, all at Prairie View. And we just, you know, we kind of wanted to give our feedback to Beyonce and just respond like, you know, Beyonce, we definitely would have accepted you at Clark Atlanta. I think if you would have been a student here at Clark Atlanta, you would have been phenomenal. You know, we had a lot of, you know, talent. We had a lot of women that had that swag, that had that ability to, you know, be a top artist just like yourself. A lot of them did not have that platform, but some of them, you know, a lot of women are still doing their thing today. But I feel like if you were a student at Clark, yeah, you would have fit right in with the rest of the students. We had a lot of celebrities at the school, a lot of celebrities that actually, you know, started their careers at Clark Atlanta. And, you know, ended up taking off and they're doing pretty well for themselves now. You got a lot of important people that work in the background, in the production phase and stages of TV and film, music, whatnot. So, yeah, Beyonce, you would have been right at home in Atlanta. You know, just the culture of our city in Atlanta. You know, Atlanta is, you know, it's a historically black city, you know, and, you know, from your Joseph E. Lawrence to Martin Luther King to Alonzo Herndon to all of these figures that had, you know, that played a role in the civil rights days. You know, they paved the way for us. They paved the way for us to be able to move how we move in Atlanta. So I think as a black woman and as a black artist with your talents and your ability, you would have definitely stood out and been amongst the elite at Clark Atlanta. As a football team member, I think you would have probably been on the dance team. We had a dance team at the time. It was called Essence in the band. And Clark Atlanta band was always pretty good. You know, we had a pretty huge band. They participated in Battle of the Bands that was held at the Georgia Dome. And so I could really see you, Beyonce. I could see you dancing with the Essence dance team. My ex-girlfriend danced on the Essence dance team. So yeah, if you were at Clark, I probably would have shot my shot as well. You know, I probably would have tried to get at you. So no disrespect to Jay-Z, but man, yeah, I would have been on her. Just from my experiences at the school and being a native of Atlanta, you know, I just want to say this in closing, as my HBCU story, that we love our HBCU. You know, we always going to give back. We're always going to help Clark Atlanta keep the doors open. And Beyonce, if you really want to know, you know, how our experience was you're more than welcome to come to the homecoming. You're more than welcome to come out and party with us every year at the homecoming. And we would love to actually have you as an honorary alumni, you know what I mean? But in a nutshell, that's me, that's my story, and I see you guys next time.
You make me happy. This you can bear. Oh,